bagong season ng The Tim Yap Show. Oh, how fast time flies. Malingat lang ako, akalain ninyo matanda na naman ng isang taon itong si Rosa. Anyway, let's cap off the season tonight sa isang masayang baliktanaw.
Salamat sa inyong walang sawang suporta para sa nag-iisang show tuwing More Night na ang tanging misyon ay magpaligaya ng buhay ng mga taong kagaya mo, kagaya ko, at kagaya nating lahat na merong
insomnia!
Kaya naman, bibitin ko ba? Siyempre, hindi. Umpisa natin ang party.
So, tonight, balikan natin ang pinakatumatak na personalities ng Season 7. Umpisa natin sa mga pasabog na revelasyon.
I think the magazine was Hot Stuff Magazine. Mm-hmm. I think that was the most sexiest magazine na nagawa ko talaga, na parang apple lang ata yung kinover dun sa ano ko. Parang ganon, may apple. Tapos, nung nakita ko yung picture, Tim, talagang hindi na iwasan, talagang tumutuloy.
Talaga?
Diba ako na parang,
bakit? Bakit green yung apple? Dapat red.
Red nga yung apple.
Red nga yung apple, okay.
Red nga yung apple. Pala, sana nga green na lang kasi parang hindi ko masyadong, kaso nakafocus talaga dun kasi red yung apple. Tapos, yun lang yung takip sa katawan ko. Sabi ko kay Sandra, erase mo yan. Tapos stress is under sa akin. Yun yung pinaka nahirapan talaga ako. It's really hard. Like, people doesn't really know na. Tama ka, it's really hard na pag tinitingnan mo parang, ay, ang sexy, ganyan. Pero yung process nung napinagdaanan for that photoshoot was really hard. So, okay din naman kasi kahit papano, because of that kind of image, nakilala ako, yung ganun. So, I'm really still thankful na napunta ako doon.
It served its purpose at the time.
Yes, at the time.
Sabi ko kung may
nag-ape na sa'yo. Honestly, I've always been, you know, a fighter. And kahit naman gano'ng kakatapang, there are still situations in life na mangyayari pa rin sa'yo yun eh. At saka kahit naman fighter ka, you don't always fight back. You know, sometimes you really just suck it up and offer it up to God and say, you know
sometimes
what?
Sometimes you learn how to take a few steps
na,
back.
Yes, you. Sometimes you try to be the bigger person. Intindihin mo din. Minsan, you don't understand why the person is doing what they're doing. Kahit na mali, gusto mong bigyan ng logical, good reason behind it somehow. So, of course,
I give them the benefit of the doubt na, hindi, baka naman kasi ganito.
Yes, kahit na nakakainis or masakit, you just have to sometimes. So, syempre, yes.
When time na yon, when you wanted to take your life.
Okay.
No? Paano mo naisipang tumawag sa Boys Night Out?
Kasi naisipan ko lang, nasa table ako that time. Around mga 7 PM ng gabi, wala akong magawa. The topic is YOLO. Wala akong kaibigan that time eh. Inon ko ng radio before. I on the radio, Boys Night Out. Sige, tawag ako. Wala akong kausap eh. I don't have friends. Wala akong tumawag na ako. Ah, hello, Boys Night Out. Kinausap na ako. And then I cry out loud. Parang wala na. Parang gumuguho yung mundo ko, team. I don't know what happened that time. Pero suddenly, sinagot nila yung tawag ko. And yun.
So, pero at that time talaga, nasa utak mo talaga na balak mo talagang tumalon ng building.
Yeah, kasi first time ko ma-in love eh. Sa buong buhay ko kasi.
Heartbroken din.
Kasi sa buhay ko, team, alam mo naman ako dati. Bukan ako eh. Nerd ako eh. Isang beses lang ako nagmahal sa buong buhay ko. Yun lang yung babae na yun. And apparently, yun. Pinagbalik niya ako sa iba. Ang lungkot niya eh.
Friend mo sa Dota. Kadota mo.
Kadota pa yung office.
Kadota niya.
Mo yun.
Ang sakit.
Dahil kasi nasa nakakostume.
Yan na!
Rosa, show your abs.
Surprise!
Yung balay sa balay, no? Okay, who's who Rosa wants to see? Okay, Rosa wants to see who has the hardest abs. Who among you guys have the hardest abs? Actually, me eh, pero you know, alam na lang tayo yun. Who? Or?
Yeah.
And she wants proof. Proof.
Take it out?
Yes.
Now he's pretending to be shy. Woo!
You said Jasia.
Apps daw.
Don't touch us. Yeah, don't touch too much.
Ano ba advice mo, Jojo, sa mga tao when they're feeling low? How do you get back on the high?
For me, is an advice ko sa kanila is be smile always. Because there's no price in smiling. If you smile, haters gonna hate things.
Yes.
They hate us?
They hate us because they ain't us.
I love that.
They hate us.
Did you say anus?
They
hate us because they're anus.
They're anus.
Oh, diba?
They're anus. But when you're low down, just smile and everything will be alright. Kasi ano nangyayari sa atin ngayon, bukas iba naman eh.
Tama.
Always, anything has a reason. In every season, there's a reason.
Diba? Yes, a reason for every season. Yeah. And they anus.
Because ano, they anus.
In other words, quit kayo.
Yeah,
pero another notable thing we did this season ay we gave tribute to the moms.
But what is your main dream, main goal? Why are you doing all of this?
Because my daughter is ano na, magka-college na next year.
Okay.
So uh-oh. Kim Nicole is already going to be in college next year. I want to give her the best education. So alam naman natin the universities are very, the enrollment fees are very expensive.
Yes,
it's very expensive.
Not just the enrollment, yeah, not just the tuition fee, pati yung mismong through the course of
yes,
her course.
Yes, and she wants to go to our school,
LaSalle. So malapit na yan. So next year na yan.
Yes.
How does it feel na meron kang anak na magka-college na?
Ayun na, trabaho, tik tik tik.
Oh, you know what I find really cool, Kaylee, is that you are, how old are you now? 45 years old? 45?
Four.
Okay. 4 years old, you see this little cute girl, but from what we read and what we know, Jackie, at 3 years old, she was diagnosed with ALL.
Yes, leukemia.
It's a leukemia, and she spent her third and a half year of growing up, going through chemotherapy,
mm-hmm.
and it's like three times a week.
Yeah.
When you were going to the hospital, what did you feel?
I felt like I was brave and strong.
Because you are brave and strong, right? And so now, by the grace of God, you're very, you've healed and there's no more, let go of those demons inside. That, like,
right.
What is that show that you guys were watching?
Monsters Inside Me.
Yes, there's some monsters inside
remember
me.
That?
And, remember that? Yeah. And so now you're fully healed and you're happy and healthy, and now you're the one going to the hospital and telling the kids that, hey, it's okay.
It's okay to be brave, right?
Yeah.
Do you help the kids there when they're a little bit scared? Yeah? You want to tell them the one time that you were showing another kid your porta-cap to make him brave?
Yeah.
What is a porta-cap?
A porta-cap is like when you have a line here, your porta-cap is there.
It's a line. It's an implant under the skin. So it's a line so that they can insert the chemo medicine.
Yes.
Because yung chemo masyado matapang.
Oh, oh, oh.
So if you do it through like yung IV usual where the
yes,
IV goes,
yes,
it can actually burn your skin and your veins. So they do that so for safety.
Yes.
This is a line that runs through her neck and then goes down.
Wow. But so Jackie, such an adorable little girl, little woman, because she's such an adult. How did you, diba? You are, right? But Jackie, so like, three and a half, and then, of course, you had to be strong for your daughter also.
Yes, of course.
And going to the hospital. How did you feel during those moments?
It was tough. Yeah. Of course, you don't want to see your kids sick, right? You never want to see them hurt. And then here you are with your only girl. You're like having to do all these things at an early age. And she was, you know what? She was so healthy. Wala namang signs eh, hindi naman siya sakitin. So never mong iisipin na she would ever get sick.
Yes.
So yung feeling ko parang, syempre parang, alam mo yung, ano yung term na yun, yung nagunaw yung mundo mo when they told me. But then, I just stuck to prayer. I kept praying about it. And then, ano nafe-feel ko lang, parang sinasabi lang ni Lord, it's like, just hang on to me and trust. Trust what I'm gonna do. I won't let you down. And just find a purpose in it.
Oh, first part pa lang yan ng throwback natin for a very successful season. Stay tuned for more awesome moments dito lang sa The Tim Yap Show. Ikaw, na hashtag ka ba? Welcome back to the Kenyap Show. Tuloy lang ang ating reminiscing from all the loving na nakuha natin for season 7. Kung kanina binalikan natin ang kanikanyang gimmick na handog ng sangkatutak natin mga guests, eto't balikan naman natin ngayon ang mga may bagong paandar at mga pasabog.
Nila. Kasi hindi sila ganun kasanay na may mga runners dun eh. So isang time hinabol na ako ng aso dahil yung guy na nagtatrain nung canine, binitawan niya yung aso niya. Nakita yung aso niya nung tumatakbong tao.
So, eh, mali mo, nagtatrain din siya for a run. Yung,
oo diba? Nga naman, di ba? Tsaka nagtatrain kung paano maghabol lang magnanakaw, di ba?
Diba?
Well, akala niya magnanakaw ako, so hinabol ako ng aso. So medyo nakakatakot yun kasi
pero
hindi naman yun.
Pero mabilis yung takbo mo nun.
Oo, napabilis. Pero magagalit ka rin ng konti kasi hindi naman shih tzu yung mahabol sa'yo eh.
Oo, or canine.
Canine eh, medyo mapangil eh. So, pero yun, tapos ano ba, nadrawan ako 3 times. Tapos hindi sinasadya, hindi parang, oy, si Yael, puh, hindi ganun ha. Parang ano.
Nagkataon lang talaga may padura at
meron.
Ikaw lang yung sumalo.
Exacto, para sa basketball, tawag doon lead pass. Papasa mo sa harap eh, pag ganyan, para, exacto, sa low layup. Dito,
tapos sa likod.
So parang, tapos titingin ka lang eh, parang, why? Tapos why yung, nakatingin din sa iyo yung bata na parang, sorry kuya, hindi ko alam na nandyan ka eh. Tapos parang, bakit hindi? Anyway,
you also have a planner.
Yes, it's actually called the Be the Best You Planner. So it's a school planner. Mm-hmm. It starts from June 2015 to May 2016 kasi it really caters to college students, high school, college kasi iba yung calendar nila, diba?
Oh, so it's a planner to plan your what? To plan your academic life.
Yes.
And beyond.
I actually have a planner with me.
Why
right
perfect
here.
Yan because I need to plan my education.
Ta-da.
Wow, so nice.
So, and it's really helpful kasi aside from the usual like planning stuff, meron akong inspirational quotes inside. So I gathered a lot of quotes from my friends like Bel Daza, Georgina Wilson, my sister of course, and my brother.
Cute.
Like Jasmine Curtis also contributed some of the quotes there. So every month there's an inspiring quote from them and from me.
Yes.
How I went through college, kung ano yung mga pinagdaanan ko, kung paano ako makakatulong sa kanila.
Meron ding mga health, food, at good luck tips tayong binibigay.
Okay, let's go molecular and all that.
Oh, 62 degree egg, ganon.
Yeah, there's no basic understanding of the real science of what molecular gastronomy is.
Basta uso.
Basta uso at magic tricks.
Oh.
Mas maganda kung you have a deep understanding. All these molecular chefs that are very successful, they have a very deep understanding of classics, of tradition, of culinary history.
Of science.
Yes. And these are all combined into an interdisciplinary approach. Now, what could be done? Let's look back at history and let's develop Filipino dishes. Because we're so stagnated at crispy pata, kari kare, sinigang. What can be done?
So what can be done?
Lots of things can be done. We showed it during Madrid Fusion.
Yes.
Our little booth in the Albay booth showed that we could pair off food with wine. Everybody was saying, oh, Filipino food.
Hindi pang wine, hindi siya pang ano, pang pairing.
Filipino food is difficult to pair off with wine. Only because they're not oriented. They have to know wine, and they also have to know Filipino food.
For people who don't know, what is the main difference on yung mga nasa tractor, yung mga may machine, may chemicals, and what it does to our body as compared to stuff that's organic and that's prepared, of course, with love?
Yes. That's the most important, that it's prepared with love. So we approach our produce with a lot of love and reverence. So we consider the whole farm as one living ecosystem, like a living organism. So even the way our staff are treated and how we train our staff to reverence what they're planting, and
you pass on that energy. Eh?
Yeah, absolutely. That's what you were explaining earlier with your African tulip, right? The same thing. That's the most important. But in the physical sense, that we're chemical free, completely chemical free. And some people think that if you cook your food, mawawala na yung chemicals. Mm. But that's not completely true.
So there's still remnants there.
That go
it stays. It's in their veins.
Yes,
kumbaga.
Yes. And then it's in the oils, because if you use it with the skin, you know, you, I mean, even if you clean it, it's in the root system. And
sarap, di ba?
Yeah.
Oh.
And it's been proven, and it's all backed up by science.
Yes.
I work on this book for the last 12 years or so.
This book is this book?
This book, yeah.
Right?
This book right here. This is the cover. Well, the marketing team wanted this cover. I wanted the one wearing a shirt. So,
Uy, girl, nagpahambon ka ba eh.
Well, oh. They say it's sell. But I want to show you what I looked like yes. before when I let go. So, this was me a long time ago.
Oh, di ba? Oh.
Because of the science of eat more and exercise less, I was able to transform myself like this.
Oh, thank you very much, Tim.
So how has training been? I know it's been rigorous and yeah. kakaiba.
Kakaiba. The moment I was crowned, I felt the responsibility already.
Yes.
Pagbaba ko pa lang backstage, naramdaman ko na agad na, okay, mag-training na ako, kailangan ko ng mag-grocery dahil naubusan na ako ng healthy food at home. Mag-gym na ako, mag-aaral na ako, gagawin ko na to, ganyan, ganyan, ganyan. As soon as I was crowned, I felt like, it didn't feel like parang, oh, panalo ko, ganyan. It felt like, okay, back to work.
Right wow. So, wala kang ano, I'm gonna have a victory party. It was just like, okay, back to the drawing board.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And so months and months of preparation. Now that you are gearing towards the pageant, no? Anong klaseng ano? Ano ba yan? Nag-aaral ka pa maglumakad? Remember, I remember a lot of the beauties that are trained by Jonas Cafun.
Yeah.
From your group, no? Meron kayong mga signature walk.
Yeah.
Alam mo yon? Is there a Pia Wurzbach signature walk that you're working on?
Yes, we're working on the walk, but there's no name for it
yes,
yet.
Yes.
And we're not the ones who name it. The people do it. The people name the walk. So far, I don't know. I don't know.
Words back to back.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know,
that's always my aim, to inspire.
Exactly. You know, your journey has taken you to, you know, places far and wide, and now, you know, now you have a family.
Yes. Yes, I'm really so blessed. I didn't realize that having a family could be so fulfilling, also being a true wife and a mother. Kasi yung una kong failed marriage, wala, hindi ko naranasan yun.
Oh.
But now, so, I'm really so blessed.
So at that time, when you were experiencing your former marriage, so ano yun, na-feel mo, is this what family is? Is
yeah.
this what a marriage is?
I felt so shortchanged. I had high expectations. I was so in love with love. I left everything to be with this man who was my Italian prince. Tapos ganun pala.
So, ay?
Parang, ay.
Parang into the woods.
Unmet expectations. Ganun lang. Yun. So wala, 2.5 years lang. But now, everything that I had dreamed of about being married, about being a wife and being a mother, is now being fulfilled and even better.
Sab, how is your life now as Mrs. Baccaro?
It's been great. I've never been happier. I hope it's not just the honeymoon stage because we've been having the best time of our lives, and I can't say anything bad about it right now because everything is just we've been fighting less, and oh my gosh, knock on wood, we haven't fought in so long.
So you've achieved that kind of harmony. Because most people, diba, they'll always say, what advice will you give to newlyweds? Don't do it. Kaya mga jaded, diba?
Yes, totoo.
But sa inyo, you guys have made each other more balanced, you know, that there's you can totally see this sense of calm, this happy calm within you.
I think it's so important that I married my best friend, because it's like I said in our show before, when we guested here, there's just really a difference na when you're in a relationship with someone you're attracted to, if you're in a relationship with your best friend, parang you just don't want to hurt your best friend, diba?
Yes,
so
yes.
You'll never do anything stupid.
Oh, sabi ko sa inyo eh, ang dami nating pinagsaluwang moments this season 7. Promise at marami pa yan, kaya naman wag bibitiw. Dahil just like General Douglas MacArthur, we shall return. Ikaw, na hashtag ka na ba?
Welcome back to the Timmy Up Show. Feeling nostalgic pa rin tayo ngayong gabi as we look back at the season that was. Kung kanina medyo may tribute tayo sa ating mga mothers, ngayon naman magkakapili-pilipit ang ating mga dila kasama silang mga foreigners at half Pinoys.
The whole way, yeah.
That's great. And now that you guys are in the Philippines, how Filipino have you guys become?
Super Filipino, like.
Diba?
Diba?
Diba? Yeah. Oo nga. Ang galing niyo na mag-Tagalog, ha? Oo.
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 Oo. Because I'm sure a lot of Filipinos, they just assume that you guys can speak Filipino. Mm. And they'll talk to you in full Filipino. Yeah. How would you guys say, oo, oo, oo?
Well, all I hear usually is, hi, ma'am, sir. Mm. Hi, ma'am, sir, po. And, you know, that's kind of what I've picked up.
And you go, oh.
And I just go, I just nod my head. I got so, one, salamat, yeah. You know.
I got one line I know. I say this. Ano gawa mo?
Ano gawa mo? Kailang tagtigan mo, ano gawa mo sa akin?
And patay gutom ako.
Oo, patay gutom ako.
We just get to work, 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 and then have fun, and then work.
And then, well, does work ever get too much? Like, too taxing? Like,
sometimes,
like, you know,
last time I had shooting 24 hours, and then I went directly to taping, doing 24 hours ulit, parang nalito ako doon.
Nalito ka na doon? Hindi naman magaling ba mag-Tagalog eh.
Hindi.
Are you still also learning to
Yeah, Tagalog. Say, I have a twang because I speak Bisaya fluently also, so parang...
Sige nga, sagutin mo ngayon to ng Bisaya.
Kasi mong ganahan mo story ng mo.
So you're more fluent in Bisaya than you are in Tagalog.
Bisaya should be my first language.
Oh, for some people, that's really their first language.
Music video, grabe, we shot that in Ilocos pa, and then we did another music video earlier this year, which was Hush with Nadine.
Yes.
And then we just really launched the album last month, 2 months ago. So it was super parang
whirlwind for you.
Crazy for me kasi 'di ba naalala mo before I was making kwento na gusto ko talaga kumanta.
Yes. Kaya nga ang ganda na I would hear it from you na itong gusto mong gawin, and then you know a few months after you'll tell me, "Hey Tim, dito na ginawa ko na." And I'll see it and I'll see it being super appreciated by your audience.
Thank you.
'Di ba? So parang ang ganda na nakikita ko na your progress is based on your actions also. Kasi some people will just wait and sleep and wait and sleep, but you make it happen.
Thank you, thank you. I'm actually super duper lucky kasi parang feeling ko rin naman parang you can't just wait for your dreams to come true. You can't just sleep nga and dream. You need to wake up and dream again. So parang I'm very, very lucky that the people around me get to parang carry me up and help me do everything. So super perfect lang yung the environment, the vibes around. So very lucky.
Marami rin tayong nalaman sa mga karansaan ng ating mga guests.
Ano lang eh, hindi ko in-expect na malaking production siya. So when I got to the set, parang everything is so pulido lahat eh, kasi the crew was in sync talaga sila. Sobrang, we just had to act, we just had to do our job. We don't have to mind na yung stress sa set, kung ano man. So, enjoy lang namin, nag-bonding kami. Sila Archie Alemania, sila Joe M. Bascon. Sobrang, I made friends with them. Family kami, si Kuya Jan talagang. Like, sa movie, ganun din yung kami in real life.
Why? Bakit may mga ibang times when you're working on a movie set na stressful also for the actors?
Yeah, you can't help it kasi dahil minsan hindi sila nakaka-coordinate or meron sila mga, you know, unforeseen events na nasi-stress ka. Siyempre, ma-affect ka ng bad vibes na ganun. Buti nga kayo, kahit puyat na kayo eh.
May insomnia kasi yung mga yan.
Go,
nagising po ko tayo. Diba?
Well, I used to see myself on screen.
Yes.
So maybe it's...
You're used to that.
Yes, but one thing is, I always cry every time I see the scenes that reminds us where we are right now as Filipinos.
Yes,
I'm getting too serious.
No, but and
when we are now as Filipinos. I mean, parang nakakaiyak na are we still here? I mean, after 115 years.
And tayo pa rin nagco-cause ng problema for ourselves,
yeah,
diba? That was
like
such a poignant line there, diba?
Yes, yes. So talagang naiiyak ako. I mean, siguro ganun naman talaga ako sa kahit sa whatever project I do. I still get affected while I'm watching it.
What a journey it has been, sabi nga ng kanta. But the end is not in sight, sabi pa rin ng kanta. Asahan ninyong things will only get better for us dito lang sa The Timmy App Show. Pansamantala muna kaming mamamaalam ni Rosa as we prepare for you a bigger, better, and brighter season. Excited ka na ba? Ako rin. That's it for now, mga ka-good vibes. Thanks for watching and see you next season. Good night.